Squad scanning for hostiles now.
Not today, scum. Escort one to Overlord. Spring the trap.
We have you now.
This one is mine. Blast! So close.
No matter. Their story won't warn others against challenging us. Let's regroup.
Commander.
Malgus.
Your assistance with the 38th Fleet's operations has been exemplary. But I am now recalling them for a special assignment. Emperor Vauron wishes you to join a meeting of the Dark Council aboard Vikan Space Dock. We will discuss the details of the operation there. I am told the Council looks forward to hearing your voice among them once more.
The last time I joined a meeting of the Dark Council, I killed one of them.
All the more reason to respect you. We await your arrival. Malgus out.
The Meridian Complex. A state-of-the-art Republic shipyard. It nears completion on the planet Corellia. My spies report that it can produce ships faster than any of our shipyards and at half the energy cost.
That hardly seems possible.
Based on the technical readouts Zarian has acquired, I assure you it is entirely possible. Perhaps it is even a conservative estimate.
A dire threat indeed. But the solution is obvious enough. Malgus, Krovos, how would we destroy the Republic's shiny new toy?
By securing our frontline positions and withdrawing all but the most crucial warships, we have formed an assault armada of unrivaled size and power.
Under our command, this mighty fleet will burn the Republic's new shipyard to ash and destroy any hope of victory that might remain among their people.
Is the shipyard your only target? Do you have plans for the rest of the planet?
We may pursue additional targets of opportunity, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We have gathered enough fuel ships to carry our fleet to Corellia without stopping. Our enemies are in no such position. The Republic will scramble reinforcements from all corners of the galaxy. Wherever they stop to resupply, we must disable or destroy them.
We have already identified one likely refueling point for the Republic ships. The planet Onderon.
Conveniently, I am already engaged in operations to undermine Republic control of that planet. However, my forces are meager, to say the least. But with the aid of the Alliance and its commander, I am confident that I can successfully delay any Republic reinforcements that pass by.
Your predecessor wasn't the most focused ally. I hope you do better.
I'm confident that we'll work well together.
Splendid. The die is cast. Zarian, continue gathering intelligence on the shipyard and its defenses. Anathel, Shah, I trust you will share all necessary resources in a cordial and supportive manner.
Of course.
Perfect. We are adjourned.
Commander, fancy meeting you here.
Major Anri. Are you joining the mission on Onderon?
Nah, I pulled Darth Shah's operation this time. We're headed for some mined-out rock called Metshar. But word is we might catch up groundside on Corellia.
Everyone with a strong arm or sharp aim is heading for Corellia. Should be quite a battle.
If you're there, the rest of us probably won't even get the chance to lift a finger.
Major Anri, I need to speak with the Commander. Alone.
Of course, my lord. Please excuse me. Until next time, Commander.
As Sith, it is our nature to seek our own advancement. The Dark Council may have changed, but that drive remains. Victory on Corellia benefits us all. It advances us all. Should Lord Savik or any other council member forget their priorities in my absence, the Emperor grants you leave to remind them.
Some may need harsher reminders than others.
Victory on Corellia is our only concern. Losses in pursuit of that goal are acceptable. Lord Savik awaits you. Farewell, Commander.
Come in, Lana. Our objective is Onderon. Take everyone we can spare. You'll be briefed on arrival.
Understood. We'll depart for Onderon at once.
Welcome to Onderon. This is the Royal Hunting Lodge of King Petrith, the current ruler of the planet.
Onderon has been a Republic planet for centuries. Not that Petrith cares, he just wants to sell his planet's resources to anyone willing to pay.
Which is where the Empire comes in.
Exactly. Petrith's greed makes him an easy target for Savik to manipulate. But his nobles aren't playing along.
Petrith may have the throne, but the nobles have control of the capital city and day-to-day operations. If they learn of his Imperial ties, he could be deposed.
And what of the Republic fleet we're meant to destroy?
Still gathering in orbit. They're preparing for refueling and resupply operations.
Savik doesn't have the resources to attack the fleet head-on, so we're pretty sure she's gonna trick Petrith into doing it for her.
What are your impressions of Darth Savik and King Petrith?
Savik is shrewd, capable. She clearly prefers to keep herself out of any direct combat. Petrith is a fool, but controllable. He'll be no challenge.
Ready to get started?
I was surprised to find you absent upon my return from the Senate, my king. Do you expect to visit the capital soon?
I will return when it suits me.
We have matters to discuss. When do you think it would suit you to return?
You overstep, Senator. It is your job to share my decisions with the Republic, not to question them. Do not bother me again! The nobles' meddling was bad enough without Nebet to stir them up further. This is intolerable. Am I not king? Do I not rule this world?
They clearly don't respect your power, dear king. And to send the senator back here. Perhaps the Republic believes you need more supervision. But you need not concern yourself. I have brought a powerful ally to ensure nothing comes of your enemy's plans. Allow me to introduce the Alliance Commander.
I rule my own planet, too. We have much in common.
Well, I'm sure yours is nice, too. Welcome. Nebet's provocations have utterly drained me. A hearty meal will aid my recovery. Do enjoy your visit.
As you can see, the king all but eats from my hand. He is the key to our victory here. Onderon's capital is equipped with powerful defensive cannons that could easily destroy the Republic fleet in orbit. The cannons cannot be operated remotely, but if we spur the king into a civil war against his nobles, the distraction will suffice. We will infiltrate the capital amid the chaos of battle, seize control of the guns, and eradicate the Republic fleet before they even realize they're in danger.
Petrith is too stupid to be reliable. I doubt he can make this happen for us.
As long as we are here to guide him, he will do what's required. Petrith already suspects that his nobles are moving against him. We need to push their paranoia further. Through intermediaries. I have hired a band of mercenaries to infiltrate the hunting lodge and assassinate the king. Fortunately, you will swoop in to defeat these deadly attackers just in time. You will save the king, earn his trust, and push him further from his nobles all at once.
Can you tell me anything specific about these mercenaries?
They're an interesting mix. Gand finds men with droids in support. An odd group, but they have a reputation for skill. If my calculations are accurate, the mercenaries will arrive any moment now. I'll be happy to guide you to them over the comm. Good luck.
I take it the ruthless assassins have been dealt with. Now that the area has been secured, we can exit the safe room.
This is an outrage! They think they can kill me? Me! I am the King of Onderon!
Once they realized your strength, Nebet and her Republic conspirators knew they could no longer hope to control you. Killing you was their only option.
But I'm the King!
Yes. I have deployed my droids to defend the premises. I assure you that you're now quite safe.
Good, good, excellent. Well done, yes.
My king, what of your cousins? They're still at the ancient proving grounds.
And? What do they have to do with any of this?
It's possible they're in danger too, good king. If your enemies are attacking you, they could also target your family. But the commander who valiantly saved your life can certainly rescue your cousins as well.
Good then, get on with it. My blaster, I need my blaster. Oh, where did I put it?
His gullibility exceeds even my greatest estimates. We have given him fear. Now, we must give him anger. Find the king's cousins at the ancient proving ground. Kill them. Then spread evidence that Nebet is to blame. Petrif will demand retribution, and we'll have our diversion.
You can start the funeral preparations now, if you like.
Onderon's tombs may profit more from my plans than we will. The Onderon wilds are treacherous. You should take a guide with knowledge of the terrain. Speed is crucial. The Republic fleet is about to begin refueling, but my plan is unfolding perfectly. Victory will be ours.
Ah, Commander. I believe I found a pair of local guides we can trust.
Jacaro? C2-D4?
Better than they treated us, clearly. We really need this.
Do you know your way around this planet?
Have you forgotten my many tales of our service to the late Queen Lena? If only her son had inherited her wits, or grace, or looks.
I shall leave you in their capable hands, Commander. Good luck.
Hands.
Not one step closer. Identify yourself.
I don't talk to corpses.
What? I don't understand.
Ugh! I'm tired of all this nonsense. Let's go back to the capital.
Get down! For Onderon!
How dare you!
Our cousin is the king!
I'm sure he'll be very upset about your deaths.
What? You don't mean...
You'll regret this!
Savik, Petrif's cousins are dead.
Such a tragedy. I'll inform the king they were slain hours ago. Well done. Savik, out.
Commander, good. The King is attempting to rally support for an invasion of the capital. Your efforts were beyond successful. My plan unfolds precisely as scheduled. The King will rejoin us momentarily, having realized he lacks the military support to reclaim his palace. He will ramble about traitors, demand the blood of his enemies, and remind us yet again that he is king. Then, with the simplest prodding, he will realize where to acquire the troops he needs.
What do you have in mind? Imperial reinforcements, more support from the Alliance?
Neither, actually. Observe.
Traitorous! Cowardly! I want them all dead! The Bet, the nobles, my worthless bannermen, the Republic, all of them!
Dear King, surely your allies rallied to your cause.
Some did, and they will receive a king's reward, but far too few. We cannot take the capital with such a small force.
I only wish the Empire could provide more aid in these dark times. No one else on this world has the strength to challenge the nobles and their off-world comrades. It seems impossible to believe.
No. Onderon's strength is not yet lost. There is one group. They've hated the nobles for years. Tried to undermine all relations with off-worlders. I always dismissed them as backward and paranoid, but perhaps they were right all along. About the Republic, that is. They are known as the Untamed. Their leader is a Beast Lord, a Kuru. He's a keeper of Onderon's old ways, but he will not join us easily.
Please, King Petrith. If we cannot supply the troops you so badly need, at least allow us to win this ally for you.
The Kuru and his Untamed are proud and stubborn. They have no more love for me than the nobles. I'm not sure how you could secure their allegiance.
This Beast Lord might not possess your level of intelligence, but then, who does? I'm sure he can be reasoned with.
Indeed, yes. Even a fool could see the wisdom in joining my cause. I will prepare myself for war. Good fortune to you, friends.
All too easy. The Untamed are Onderon's only other major group. Once they're weakened by joining this attack, they will pose no further threat to Imperial operations.
There is a proper way to seek an audience with them. An old ritual. They love old rituals.
Excellent. And one more thing. I've learned that Akoru's elder brother, Rutan, once trained as a Sith. He died fighting Republic forces on Hoth. The rest of the Untamed aren't aware of Brutan's service. To leave Onderon and serve off-worlders would be abhorrent to them. Perhaps a useful bit of leverage over Akoru.
How did that happen, exactly?
Brutan's master served Darth Jadus. I expect they hope to train him, then send him back to seize leadership of the Untamed and disrupt Onderon's Republic-friendly regime. Unfortunately, that plan never came to fruition. It would have made our task much simpler. I must finish preparing my own droids for the assault. It is best if any Imperial identifying components are removed. Good luck.
Beacons are lit, and the ancient rites are observed. I am Akoru, Beast Lord of Onderon. You have shown your respect. Now speak your purpose here.
King Petrith needs your warriors to help him attack the capital.
We have heard of the king's squabbles with his nobles. Nothing on Onderon is hidden from this world's true masters. I'm not surprised that Petrith would seek outside help. His blade has never tasted the blood of his foes. But why should I help a fool against his enemies? I have no love for any of them.
Because I know your brother's secret. I can tell your followers, or you can do what I say.
But... What do you believe you know about my brother?
He trained to become a Sith like me. He died serving off-world masters.
Curse you! Bruton was a hero to us all. I will not see his reputation marred. Untamed! Hear me! Rally all warriors! The hour of our revolution is at hand! Bring forth Crashalock! He and all of our beasts shall have a half portion! Let them be fueled for the fight, but still hungry for victory!
Ha! Crashalock! But his beast's name! It's actually a pretty clever pun, if you speak ancient Onderonian at least. I'm honestly impressed.
Petref will learn what real strength is. We will show the galaxy the true power of Onderon.
I'm telling you, an idiot doesn't come up with a pun like that. Or speak a forgotten language. Insane? Perhaps. Xenophobic? Bigoted? Murderous? All fair. But he's not an idiot. Not the bigger idiot, anyway.
Debating relative idiocy, are we?
They can't decide who's more foolish, Petrif or Okoru.
Really now?
Onderon, your conquering king returns! After this day, none will question my power!
Excuse me?
He said you're sure to win, O mighty king.
I am indeed. Our noble forces await us. To war!
Between Petrif and Okoru, the capital's security forces should be adequately distracted. While they attack the main gate, my droids will blow open the city wall near a sewer bypass. That will be your entry to the Orbital Defense Cannon's control center. Once you destroy the Republic fleet in orbit, our victory on Corellia will be one step closer.
Where will you be during the assault?
Remotely directing my droid commandos. They will supervise Petrif and Okoru to ensure they stay on task. After all, I wouldn't want to waste all this effort we've put into undermining Onderon's government. To that end, once the fleet is dealt with, you should regroup with Petrif and his troops. If you aid them in defeating Senator Nibet and her Republic allies, Petrif can rule unchallenged as the Empire's puppet. Onderon would be ours.
You think he'll survive long enough to even reach the palace?
With our aid? I have no doubt. I will deploy my droids to clear a path. Good luck, Commander. This will be a day long remembered.
Savik, come in. The cannons are disabled. Petrif or Okoru must have damaged the power grid in their attack.
Blasted fools. We'll think of something else once the palace is secure. Please, hurry to the throne room.
All of my droids have been destroyed. I have no visibility. But if you ensure Petrif's victory, I'm sure we can find another way to disable the Republic fleet.
Please, this is our last chance. Savik out.
Onderon will return to the old ways, the pure ways. Your blood will wash away centuries of desecration.
You don't fight for Onderon. You fight for your own bigoted agenda. You fight, and you lose.
His loss is my gain, Nibet. I've beaten you. I've won!
Did you really believe you could steal the throne of the great King Petrif?
Steal your throne? What in blazes are you talking about?
no sense lying now. Your treason is over. I've won.
The Republic fleet escaped.
Oh, they have escaped for now. With the Commander's aid, I am certain we can still stop them.
The Republic fleet escaped.
This is only a setback. We have countless alternatives to pursue.
The Republic fleet escaped.
Savik failed, but her death won't solve anything.
We will depart for Corellia at once. We will find a use for you yet, Savik.
Yes, my lord. Commander, thank you.
We have no more time to waste. Onderon has been an abject failure. Another fleet of Republic reinforcements is docking at Mekshar, as Darth Shah suspected. That will be your next target. Rendezvous with Shah's forces, and ensure they succeed where Savik failed. Malgus out.
So, what's our next stop?
Set course for Mekshar.
Ah! We know it well! A mined-out asteroid converted into a fueling station. We would love to join you. If you think your alliance has room, of course. Please?
Please?
It's been a pleasure working with you again. Welcome to the Alliance.
Wonderful.
I have a shuttle prepped and ready, shall we?